Harper Audio presents Cooking for Hormone Balance, a proven, practical program with over 125 easy, delicious recipes to boost energy and mood, lower inflammation, gain strength, and restore a healthy weight. By Magdalena Wszelaki. Read by Nan McNamara. One reminder. Don't forget to download the accompanying enhancement PDF from your audiobook provider. It contains diets, meal plans, techniques, recipes, and more, and will be referred to throughout the audiobook as the enhancement. Foreword by Dr. Izabella Wentz. Many of you probably have heard from a healthcare professional that the cause of your hormonal imbalances is your genes, and that the only option you have to manage your hormones is to take a prescription medication. As a pharmacist who has dedicated my professional career to helping women with thyroid conditions get to the root cause of their health struggles, I have seen time and time again that genes are not our destiny, that we hold the power to recover our own health, and that there are often safer and more effective approaches to healing than a pill. While each person may have different symptoms, the fundamental way to heal the body is the same: support its ability to heal itself. Supporting your digestive process and your liver, and balancing your sugar levels, can give your body the boost it needs to repair and balance itself. Every time you eat a meal, you choose to support or diminish your body's healing capabilities. I have seen that using food as medicine, or food pharmacology, as I like to call it, can create profound transformations in a person's health. Food has the power to nourish, regulate hormones, improve digestion, and promote detoxification. Yet the most common foods in our standard Western diet cause inflammation, digestive distress, and erratic blood sugar levels. If we continue to eat inflammatory foods, we will continue to be inflamed. To get our health back, we must break free from the conventional and take charge of our health destiny. Magdalena Wszelaki is one of those rare people who has been where you are and has come out on the other side of healing. Fueled by her own health journey, she is a deeply passionate health coach with a special focus on using nutrition to balance hormones. Through her work with private clients and her popular hormone balancing programs, she has helped thousands of women. Magdalena and I met in 2013. I had been listening to her podcasts and was an avid reader of her blog. I was inspired by her empowering, can-do practical methods for helping women get their health back. And I thought to myself, wow, this woman is brilliant. I'd love to have her as a friend. I reached out, and we've been close ever since. I've learned so much from Magda over the past few years, from practical kitchen tips, like using a lemon squeezer, to combining calf liver with broccoli to help iron absorption. We frequently share ideas and best practices on health, nutrition, and healing. And I've always been impressed with her ability to create approachable solutions for challenging health problems. In fact, I was the one who insisted she compile her knowledge into this very book. I've also experienced the benefits of Magdalena's cooking, especially her protein, fat, and fiber, PFF, breakfasts. When we attended a conference with a group of health experts, Magdalena generously offered to make us breakfast each morning. Every day, we were treated to a healthy, creative, and mouth-watering dish. First, it was her decadent chocolate cherry smoothie, then the farmer's wife's breakfast, and finally, the breakfast casserole. We all looked forward to starting our day with her delicious meals, and everyone in the house reported that they felt calmer and more mentally clear and energetic throughout the day. And these were already very healthy people. In Cooking for Hormone Balance, Magdalena shows you how to use food to awaken your healing capabilities. Whether you've been following a healthy diet for some time or are new to the world of nutrition, you will benefit from knowing how to avoid inflammatory foods, balance your blood sugar, and use nutrient-dense ingredients. You will feel vibrant and strong, and chronic conditions that you thought were a part of your genetic makeup, a result of getting older, or normal, such as mood swings, panic attacks, acne, menstrual cramps, digestive issues, and joint pain, may resolve. Most importantly, cooking for hormone balance will help you identify the best dietary protocol for you on the basis of your unique symptoms. Whether you're struggling with estrogen dominance, PCOS, Hashimoto's disease, or adrenal dysfunction, this empowering and practical guide will provide you with a personalized plan to support your body. I know that it can be difficult to change your diet, even if you know that doing so will help relieve your symptoms. Maybe, like many of my clients, you're afraid that eating a clean diet means eating boiled chicken and steamed vegetables for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Fear not. Celebrating everything she's learned, living, dining, and cooking around the world, from Iceland, Poland, and Malaysia, to California, and now Colorado, Magdalena offers recipes in cooking for hormone balance that are distinctive, flavorful, and healthy, and will leave you nourished and satisfied while you're healing. You will not find a boring or unsatisfactory recipe here. Whether you're eating coconut kefir chia pudding for breakfast, enjoying walnut-crusted salmon for lunch, or having raspberry and green tea lime melties as a dessert, you will never feel deprived. And because they're so delicious, Magdalena's recipes will please your whole family. They'll love this food, and they won't even realize that it's good for them. You may even inspire your friends and family members to adopt a nutrient-dense, anti-inflammatory style of eating, and they will feel healthier and more balanced as a result. While the recipes are showstoppers, cooking for hormone balance also includes many of Magdalena's innovative, targeted protocols for specific conditions. You will love her hormone-balancing seed rotation method. My clients who have followed it report better moods, fewer hormonal acne breakouts, and normalized menstrual cycles. I am so grateful to Magdalena for putting her life's work and passions into this practical and beautiful guide. I know that utilizing the strategies in this book will bring you life-changing healing, many delicious meals, and lots of compliments from the people in your life. To your health. Izabella Wentz, Doctor of Pharmacy, FASCP, number one New York Times bestselling author, Hashimoto's Protocol. Introduction. Before you begin. I wrote this book because, just like you, I've suffered from many hormonal imbalances. At first, I bought into the belief that hormonal problems are genetic, or the causes are unknown. Some of you might have been told that there is little we can do about our hormones apart from taking birth control pills or supplementing our body's natural hormones. As much as this may be the case for some women, my inner wisdom was telling me that there must be more we, women, can do to help ourselves. What I have discovered on this journey is that there are no magical foods or herbs that will immediately reverse hormonal imbalances. Instead, as the guardian of your sacred body, you can create an environment that is conducive to the hormones being produced, metabolized, and excreted in such a way that you enter that balance. Just as a gardener prepares the soil for a garden to bloom and thrive so that she can later reap the benefits, so you can do the same with your body and hormonal balance. I have found that hormonal balance requires a healthy digestion, stable sugar levels, and a well-functioning liver. I see these three things as the foundation of our hormonal health. each represents one leg in the three-legged stool that is hormonal health. All three legs need to be stable for you to sit comfortably. Restoring your gut, sugar levels, and liver health will not only rebalance your hormones, but will reverse many other seemingly unconnected ailments that might have been plaguing you for years, such as seasonal allergies, hives, chronic pain, weight gain, depression, and anxiety. I have been blessed with the opportunity to lead large online communities of women who have gone through my hormone-balancing diet with life-changing results. When I polled the community about the biggest change that this way of eating had created for them, I thought I was going to read replies pertaining to weight loss, better sleep, or better mental function. To my surprise, the biggest benefit the women reported was having learned to listen to their bodies. This skill will set you free. What you will learn in this book might take away the frustration of dieting, counting calories or points, and the confusion of not knowing what is or is not healthy for you. The reason is simple. Many diets have been devised by people who got great results from a certain way of eating, so they passionately embark on getting the rest of the world to join them. As you might have found, some of these diets work for a while, and others bomb. Even though someone you know might have felt great on one of them, maybe you did not. So what is different in this book? My approach to helping you find hormonal balance is based on the principles of functional medicine that emphasize uncovering the root causes of disease and treating a person from every aspect, from diet to sleep, genetics, infections, toxic exposure, and stress. On the diet front, I'm a firm believer in bio-individuality, one of the principles of functional medicine, which means that one person's food can be another person's poison. This could be due to many reasons, including genetics, current gut health, liver health, or the environment a person is living in. Certain truths are true for all. For instance, processed foods, excessive sugar, alcohol, drugs, and getting powered by coffee and stress will harm anyone's health. But the rest is subjective and can depend on the complex biochemistry of an individual. Take sauerkraut, which is a vitamin C-packed, probiotic-rich food. Good for you, right? Maybe. A person with histamine issues, candida yeast overgrowth, or a carbohydrate sensitivity will end up with hives, anxiety, vaginal itchiness, and a bloated tummy after eating sauerkraut. Not much of a health food for that person, is it? The same unhealthy reactions can occur with many other foods, such as nuts, seeds, grains, or even the healthiest of vegetables. Often, I am asked what specific foods, supplements, or herbs to take to rebalance hormones, and quickly, too. This question comes from decades of conditioning by the medical establishment, which tells us that there is a medication and a pill for every pain and discomfort we experience. And these days, as a replacement for a pharmaceutical pill, some people seek instant relief from a few foods, supplements, and herbs. As much as I've created comprehensive guides, I didn't want to write a gimmicky book that promises a quick recovery with five magic foods or herbs, because they don't exist. Maca or black cohosh might bring some relief, but if your body is chronically inflamed from gut, sugar, and liver issues, the herbs might be only partially effective or work only temporarily. At the end of the day, food is the majority of what you put in your body, so change that first. Herbs and supplements will amplify healing when you are eating a clean diet. For some of you, it will be simple. Just eliminating gluten and dairy from your diet might resolve years of suffering. For others, and that's me, it takes some real tuning in. Don't worry, I teach you how to do it, and figuring out what foods your body loves and what it rejects. By eating the rejected foods, you are in a constant state of inflammation that won't bring you to hormonal balance and bliss. Apart from learning awesome, simple, yet nutritious recipes, my wish for you is to gain knowledge for life, eating not what is merely healthy, but what is right for you. This is no longer a diet. It's a way of eating that will nourish your body and soul for years to come, keeping you healthy and preventing future diseases so we can all meet up at age 75 to climb a mountain and pass the 30-year-olds on the trail. Come on this journey with me.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.